The Penguins have a win in the Windy City. 5-3, the final score, as Pittsburgh celebrates Evgeni Malkin's 1,000th NHL game in style with 2 points and a perfect three-game road trip.
Good morning, everybody, and welcome to Penguins Live Weekly. Certainly a memorable week for Geno and his fans and his family.
To see, first of all, Geno's son be involved, his wife got to go out to Chicago. They were there for Geno for game number 1,000. You got to treat the guys right, treat their families right. That's the Penguins' way, and it's all coming together at the exact right time.
It was Geno's time, and everyone wanted to be a part of it. 1,000 career NHL games. Sergei Gonchar wanted to be there to honor his longtime friend, while also remembering how hard some of those first few games were for Geno.
I played with Evgeni for a full season during lockout. It was a magnetic horse. Obviously, I've heard of him. You know, he has all the talent, all the abilities, but young and skinny and shy. It was a lot of pressure on him, and when he came, you know, I want to help the kid because, you know, I went through it myself. I remember how tough it was when you don't speak any English, when you have parents around you. You have to not only learn new language and, you know, get adjusted to new lifestyle, but also you have to perform. With all that, I recognize that I need to help him because otherwise it would be too tough for him. I'm here to celebrate the great achievements that he has. He played 1,000 games. Not that many guys played 1,000 games in NHL. And obviously, he's a good friend of mine, so I want to share a moment with him. Oh, Gina doesn't know. It's a surprise for him. Hello? So what's the plan? Listen. I don't have my credentials on me anymore. I don't think they're going to let me in. Okay, perfect. I'll be there at 4:45. Mm-hmm. See you soon. Bye.
Geno is a vibe. He's also a generational talent. And on a night in which all eyes were on him, he did what he's always done. He made people laugh. He made people think. And made people get on their feet.
Like.
G, on behalf of all of us, we're really proud to share this moment with you. It's awesome to have Gonch here. I know the impact that he had on you, but he had a huge impact on us as young players, so it's great that you can be here to be a part of this, Gonch. I can remember when we were here for your first game, and 17 years later, we'll be celebrating your 1,000th together, and we're proud of you. And we'd like to present you with something here. You were asking about it for last month, so.
Finally, after 1,000 games, I have a nice watch.
Happy best day in my life. I want to say thank you again. It's like an amazing organization. I know I'm not a perfect person, not a perfect player, but I do my best every day. And I just want to say one message for you all. Like yesterday, I'm youngest player here. Today, I'm almost older. You know, time like runs so quick. But just enjoy it every day, you know, guys. We know it's like we have a nice job here. I'm glad to be here like 4 more years. Special friends here too. I'm glad to be here. Thank you, guys.
We'll go play hockey.
Evgeni Malkin will get his moment now at ice level.
Good.
There is not a single person sitting here in PPG Paints Arena.
Thank you, guys. Legend, thanks.
You always wonder, how is a team going to come out of the gate here? You know the Penguins are going to be shot out of the cannon.
Let's go, guys. Let's go, 31.
Malkin, Rust, and Zucker up front.
Go, 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 go!
Penguins won with the same lineup they won in Chicago on Sunday night.
Nice shot, Zuck.
This line has been good for the Penguins during this three-game win streak.
Keep your shift short here. Keep your shift short.
Skated in by Carter, drops it up to Yonder, he's got a chance, he scores! Rutta! Just 2 minutes in, the Penguins with a 1-0 lead!
That's it, boys.
I just knew the Penguins were going to come out the way they came out there after that tribute to Geno, and they're up early.
Congrats, man.
Yeah, thank you, thank you.
Pleasure watching you. I live here, so I've seen a lot.
Oh, yeah?
It's a pleasure, man.
Thank you, man. I go.
Malkin breaks up that pass, cuts towards the net, tries to feed, hit the side of the goal, he's got it back, the pass for Rust,
This might get challenged here, so just hold the phone.
We have lucky, like, every game.
Hey, Gino, this is Max Talbot, your ex-favorite Miami. First of all, I want to say I forgive you for saying that I have a little bit bad hands.
It's like most like famous buff.
Yeah.
Really nice.
Gilbert, right side to Tandem. His wrister changed direction and goes in. Well, you felt it coming from Calgary.
Let's go, guys, let's go.
This was the first extended offensive zone shift for the Flames the whole game.
He's playing my stick, bro.
You gotta fight through that interference.
Pressure your D.
Yeah.
Because they pass GD all the time.
Yeah.
We're like between.
Well, all you really need right now is Evgeni Malkin goal, right? I mean, if you want to blow the roof off the PPG Paints Arena.
Lucky.
Both teams with a point in their pocket. They will go for the second.
We're going to a shootout tonight in Pittsburgh. Kadri's going to start us off. Nazem Kadri against Tristan Jarry. Deeks and lost control.
Here's Raquel. We know he can rip it. In between the hash marks, shoots and scores! And the Penguins strike first in the shootout.
Huberto 30% in his career. And he scores. Makes it look easy.
Second shooter of the second round, down the left wing on the forehand, shoots and scores! The captain up over the glove of Lennard.
And here you go, the man of the night.
Here's Malkin on his night and his moment, down the right side for the win on the forehand, Deeks to the backhand. Puts it in! And the stick toss!
Thank you, guys. Special night for me and my family. Great game tonight. We're still hungry. We won't play playoffs. We won't play like in final this year. We try to fight every night and try to win every night.
Best night of my life!
It was a Monday in late November. The normalcy of the season had set in. But on this day, the Penguins' practice was anything but normal. It was being held at the Highmark Hunt Armory, a celebration of our community and how much our game has grown in the city of Pittsburgh.
I want to. Which way are we going?
There's no stand, there's nothing, it's just it's nice that we kind of help the community to go there and interact with. There's not much rink in downtown.
Let's go, Pens! Let's go, Pens! Let's go, Pens!
feel like in a Miracle on Ice kind of vibe. That's a sick setup, actually.
How you doing, guys? Well, this was something that we had planned. It's a great opportunity for us to give back to the community. Everybody understand? Yeah? All right, here we go. Play. There you go. Nice play.
Oh, buddy. Not a chance.
One against one, go.
Yeah, over.
On the money. Go, join him. Good shot. Grab some water.
It's a nice ring for the community, though. 3 months? That's nice.
For me, this is a small gesture on our part. For us to come and practice here, I know our guys really enjoy it.
Hey, how are you guys? Thanks for coming today. You enjoy practice?
Yep.
Nice.
It's nice to play in front of kids with their level of enthusiasm. I think their enthusiasm is contagious. And when you get an opportunity to be around kids and see how excited they are to see us, for me, it elevates the energy in the practice, that's for sure.
Bye, guys.
Good afternoon. We're cutting into programming right now to bring you breaking news. Pittsburgh Penguins defenseman Kris Letang is out indefinitely after suffering his second stroke. According to a release from the team, Letang suffered the stroke on Monday, but he is not experiencing any lasting effects from that stroke and will continue to undergo a series of tests over the next week. This isn't Letang's first stroke. The 35-year-old missed more than 2 months during the 2014 season because of a stroke. Testing at that time revealed Letang was born with a very small hole in the wall of his heart.
Mike, can I just ask you, what's been the effect on his teammates, yourself, the other coaches, just given the severity, I guess, of this?
You know, the effect is that we're all concerned for Kris. Stroke is a scary word. We'll rely on our medical team. The doctors that are involved is so great, and we're appreciative for them as well. But certainly everybody's concerned.
And good evening, everybody. We start off the show here tonight with the health of Kris Letang, who suffered a stroke on Monday. The good news is that he's doing well, and Bob, we first and foremost want to wish him the best in his recovery.
Well, we do. Our thoughts and prayers certainly out to Kris Letang, his family and his kids, and take all the time you need. And boy, Kris Letang, that is a big loss for the Pittsburgh Penguins, but you know they're going to play their best here in the absence of Kris Letang.
Gensy, light it up, bud. Let's go, brother. Heavy. Yep, go, let's go. Yep.
Off we go. The Penguins and the Golden Knights meeting for the ninth time ever.
Now off the near wall, picked up by Martinez. His shot hung up, it skates in front of the net. Moves in front, Eichel shoots and he scores.
Castle going circle to circle, chance it, tight score! Power play goal, Riley Smith, roofs one.
Come on, boys, we're good. Let's go, boys. Dislocate my thumb. Just stings for a couple minutes.
The Penguins come to center. Brock McGinn with Carter into the attacking zone. Get down to the left wing corner. Check there by Ben Hutton. Carter follows on. Hutton goes down. McGinn's got the puck. Throws it to the net. He scores! Brock McGinn with a surprising turning shot has given the Penguins their first goal of the game. It's 2-1.
Could filter it through. Gensel attempts at the front score! Record Raquel!
They've come out with a different attitude here in the second period. It's not a wonder they've made the 2-2. Now you lock it down. You just suffocate the Vegas Golden Knights. You got to learn how to win these types of games.
Come on, boys. Let's go.
These are hard minutes the Penguins defense are playing here tonight.
You can reel it. Time. Yeah. Keep shooting, eh? It's coming. School boys, bend on break.
Captain's been fast here tonight.
Let's go, Cappy!
Who's behind? Ted Kapanen, he scores! He scores! Kasperi Kapanen with the go-ahead goal! Woo!
The holidays often garner nostalgic thoughts. That's no different for Penguins defenseman Jan Rutta. Since his NHL obligations kept him in Pittsburgh, the native of Czech Republic found the next best thing. Reminders of his hometown and the town he now calls home.
I can't wait for those couple days off. Just watch some classic Czech fairy tales, eat some classic Christmas cookies. I'm pretty excited. I'll take you to the glue wine store. That's the good stuff here. Yeah, I need to warm up, boys. Let's do it. Any chance I can get like a cup of Glühwein, or?
If you want to try the Glühwein, I'd be happy to give you a sample. You will hold enough.
Okay, thank you. Can I try red wine, Glühwein?
Yeah, with the family spice recipe. So it's a small father-son operation, not me.
Nice. It's great stuff. That smells good. We're a good group, and these slumps, you can call it was good, you know. You named the problems that we had, and you work on them to get rid of them and get better as a team. And ever since we ended that slump, we've been much better and playing with more confidence, and everybody just trusts everybody even more now. When I found Tanger had a stroke, I was just scared, you know. I know Tanger only a little bit, but he's just a great guy, great teammate, and nobody's gonna play like Tanger here, but there's been a lot of minutes to go around, so I just hope that he'll be good for a lot of years to come now. You just wanna take a picture?
Yeah, I'm a huge Penguins fan.
Oh, nice.
Thank
good
you
stuff,
so much.
All right, Merry Christmas.
Thank you.
Penguins back on the road after three straight wins to cap off a five-game homestand and propel themselves back into the Metro's top three.
I think the Penguins have realized that we cannot score our way into winning hockey. I think they've dedicated themselves to the defensive side of the puck, and I think they've realized we're getting just as many or maybe even more offensive chances off of our strong defensive play.
Ah, come on, Teddy, huh?
Ready.
Come on, Dan. Come on, boys, come on here.
Tristan Jarry is between the pipes for the fifth straight game. 11-3-3 on the year.
Over.
JJ Paterka again. Paterka with a hard pass in for Darlene. It's kicked out by Jarry.
That's it, Jars.
And a shot off the crossbar from Olofsson.
10 saber shots already. And this could easily be 2 or 3-0. If it isn't for Tristan Jarry.
That's it, boys.
It back for Petrie. Petrie over to Malkin. Walking with Samuelson in the lane. Want to thread that through to Gensel. He scores! Jake Gensel! This time they do cash in on the power play. Penguins with a 1-0 lead in Buffalo.
Throws it in the slot for Quinn. His backhand pass chipped out the center by Bluger.
Everything just fits on the penalty kill with Teddy Bluger in the lineup. I think everybody's game has gone up a notch since he's come back.
Hey!
Middle step. We'll lead to Joseph the clutch. Hit for Olofsson and he scores!
Cross-ice pass, Thompson throws it back door, a chance, they score! And two goals in just over a minute for the Buffalo Sabres. They take a 2-1 lead.
Crosby played net to keep the puck in the zone, what a play! Nudge the middle, and it's hit for Hyde, it's St. Mate, and it's on the rebound, score!
Rick wasted, that boy. That boy, Rick.
Skated forward by Brock McGinn, goes to Captain, back from McGinn, one time, he scores!
Anderson's going to the bench for the extra attacker. On the power play here for another 32 seconds. Centering pass on Poso, shoots and scores!
He lobs it across. Gensel looking for Raquel. Quick goes into the blue paint, and Anderson puts the glove on top. It is not like that extra swipe.
He got whacked a little bit again, and Anderson, he's looking at Gensel way out in the corner.
Skinner's
going. Skinner's going to take a penalty. He took a cross check right into the head of Gensel. That was way over the line, way over the line.
Now, if you're the Pittsburgh Penguins, you got to make them pay, right? You got to make them pay.
Pounced on by Malkin. Malkin shifting to the dot right in front. Carter right there. He scores! Jeff Carter with the KO in Buffalo.
Nice, Cartel. Out of the way, boys.
They're feeling it, you know? When they're feeling it, they just make instinctive plays. They pass the puck, and it's crisp. It's on the tape. It's hard, and it's quick. We put our opponents in a reactive mode as opposed to a proactive mode, and it's a big difference.
Yeah. Penguins coming off win number 4 in a row last night, a wild one, topping these Sabres 4-3 in overtime. You know, there are certain games and certain moments across an 82-game regular season that there's a different energy. And that comes with the return of a guy that just 12 days ago suffered a stroke, has missed the last 5 games, is one of the heartbeats here in Pittsburgh on the ice and off it. Kris Letang is back against the Sabres tonight.
Let's go.
Yeah. Shift here. Good shift here.
That's by Thompson. Back to the side of the goal. The setup for Crosby. Then it's Malkin. He's robbed. Second chance.
You get a lift knowing what that guy's been through over the last 5 games, 10 days. No matter what has been thrown Kris Letang's way throughout his career,
over.
He's overcome it, and I thought he was real solid to me.
Racing up ice. Crosby gets hit. He scores! Sidney Crosby!
Penguins 3-1 winners tonight over the Buffalo Sabres in the return of Kris Letang. A special night, the big 2 points for Pittsburgh.
That was great. As I was starting to feel better, you get anxious, you want to go back out there. And with the schedule, we don't have a chance to practice that much, so try to prepare the best I could. Timing needs to get a little bit better, but it felt good.
It's another hour of spirited Saturday morning hockey talk on the Penguins Radio Network.
P.O. Joseph winding in, fires, he scores! P.O.
What more can you say? The 7-game winless stretch is far in the rear view. This group, they seem to be resilient. They seem to be pretty fired up.
Really good stuff. In the thankless jobs, it's about getting your nose over pucks and winning those puck battles. We got to reset the mindset, go right back at it. All right, great job.
Star power, secondary scoring, stellar goaltending, special chemistry, I think. They have the most balanced lineup we've seen in a long time.
Ba-da-ba-bum-bum. What's the name of this song? I wish my best for him, ba-da-ba-bum-bum. Is that the lyrics? Probably not, eh? Ba-da-ba-bum-bum.